All right, fight fans, here we go. First in the red corner, weighing in at 160 pounds, he stands 6 foot even, age 27. From Helmond, Holland, and fighting out of Golden Glory, with a record of 70 wins, 11 losses, 33 wins by way of knockout, this man is a WFCA world champion, introducing Nikki the Natural Holdskin. And across the ring, in the blue corner, also weighing 160 pounds, he stands 6 foot even, age 31, from Amsterdam, Holland, and fighting out of Slam. His record, 53-24, with one draw, 30 wins by way of knockout. This man's the WMC European Intercontinental Champion and the WFCA Muay Thai World Champion. Here is Marco the Sniper Piquet.
Holdskin, 4 years younger than Piquet, both 6 feet tall, both weighed in at 160 pounds. So it's deja vu all over again for Piquet and Holdskin here in the Muay Thai Premier League.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee for tonight's fight, Dej Nakwi Triyapai.
Red bro.
So referee Triyapai waiting for Piquet, the sniper, against the natural.
I want clean fight. I want fair fight. Obey my command at all
times. Will they touch gloves?
Defend yourself all the time. I say stop, you have to stop. I say Bob, you start fight. Any question? Any question? Good luck to you, touch go back to the corner.
Okay, that's nice to see. There we go.
Yeah, they have behaved quite good.
Settle it in the ring. You know, show some respect to the sport and everything. Why not?
Oh, that's what I did the whole week. So
yeah,
I expect a clean, hard fight.
Sure.
At the end of the day, they're professionals, and I know that. And one of the tables is Nikki Holdskin's family, lovely wife, and a lot of fans and friends from the Netherlands. Alistair Overeem in his corner, Marco Piquet, of course, from the Pro Fighters Gym in Amsterdam, trained by Michael Polanen and Milton Felter. So a couple of your compatriots going at it here, Ernesto.
Well, people I trained with, Michael Polanen and Milton Felter, used to train with me at Horse Gym, so I know them quite well.
Team from Holdskin. Again, he ended the first meeting with a left hook in the third round.
Yeah, beautiful. Yeah.
I've had the opportunity to call Nikki Holdskin's fight for the Glory promotion in Amsterdam, a fan favorite. Very marketable. Finally made it to K1 in Japan as well, K1 Max. Now Piquet working the body with the left. Physically very similar. Who do you tend to give the edge to? There's a nice punch kick combination from Holdskin. I mean, does the first win really, you know, I mean, there's many years ago now, 3 years ago.
Yeah, I would give Nikki a little bit, let me say, the benefit of the doubt. Although they're both good, you know, they can both fight. I think Nikki has a little bit more knockout power than Marco. But they can both do it.
Nice. 3 Holdskin's 70 wins have been by knockout.
Yeah, I mean, it's very clear.
And PK, too, like you said, 30 of his 53 wins have been knockout. There's a left kick from Holdskin. Body shot by PK, follows it up with a low leg kick. Right hand countered nicely by Holdskin with a straight left. Ooh, spinning hook kick here by Holdskin.
Scores a lot of points.
Showing some of the flash and dash already here early in round one. 1 minute left in the opening frame. A great fight thus far between Holdskin and Piquet, the rematch. The first round of this round robin league format, the Muay Thai Premier League. The best Muay Thai fighters on the planet, all under one umbrella. Mauro Ranallo along with Ernesto Host and our host, part of the Punk Senior Cooling.
Oh, you see that they both have good techniques. Oh, nice move. He stole it from me. I like that one. They're so clean in their kicks and their punches. You know, they know exactly what they have to do.
Oh, nice body shot. Didn't put the body. The teeth by Holtzkin. Caught by PK. 10 seconds left in the round. It's been a good one. Ooh, Holtzkin switches stances. Southpaw lands a left kick to the body.
That's a big advantage for Southpaw fighters when they make the left low kick to the rear leg. That's like 80% chance to hit.
Mouthpiece in, seconds out, please.
For a lot of his
mouthpiece in, here we go.
Seconds out.
And I've seen him coming from the start.
Well, Wapo Basrun was a pretty good striker too in his time, right?
What?
Not bad.
Not that much. He was a little bit unlucky. Oh, wow. Why did he say that?
Remember, Basito, that was Ernesto, not me. There's a nice punch-kick combination from PK to kick off round two. He's coming out very well here.
But I'm not afraid of that.
Oh, you're not? I have you. Look at PK. I'm really impressed with his start here.
I am, me too.
Like Holtzkin comes back as well. The left kick. Oh, nice overhead right by Holtzkin.
I like to see the concentration of their faces, and they're so concentrated, and they know what they do, and they know what their opponent can do. You can see they really trained for each other and prepared.
And they know each other.
You know each other, yeah.
He came very quick with the legs, but mixing it up, and Holtzkin comes right back. Now backing him up, right cross just raises the face. Ooh, there's that reverse back elbow there, the back elbow. And I remember Anderson Silva against Tony Ferguson in a Cage Rage MMA fight using the Muay Boran, the swooping elbow, where he knocked him out. So, I mean, the elbows can be very tricky. We're seeing some good striking here. The punches and the kicks, the jab, pawing it out is Holtzkin. Just, we're nearing the midway point of the round. There's a kick underneath the armpit by PK.
Well, now you see PK attacking more, going more forward compared with the first round.
Now has Holtzkin in the corner momentarily. Holtzkin circling away, the veteran that he is, getting away from danger there. Catches him with a left hook.
Holtzkin serving, circling away, but PK keeps him.
Sweeps him away, but I like what Holtzkin did there. The left to the body, the liver right upstairs with another left hook to the head. A quick combination with the lead arm. Lead ahead.
Yeah.
He's showing very good striking, Holtzkin. Very like you saw, I mean, again, you know, I'm not just saying because you're sitting here, but very similar to your style where technique is everything.
Yeah, well, yeah, I mean, I like that. I like to see that.
Okay, slips. They rolled his ankle there. So be careful. Again, the left shot to the body, near the liver. PK just barreling inside there momentarily. 30 seconds remaining in the second round.
Still difficult to score this fight. So I see it now at the last round. Going to make the decision.
Could very well be a very competitive matchup here. PK stalking Holtzkin. Here between Holtzkin and PK, right, and there we go, the grudge match. They're showing each other what it's like. They touch gloves, so I mean, they may not be happy with each other outside the ring, but they're very complimentary of each other's skills.
They respect each other, and it should be like that. You don't have to like each other.
And look at that unique elbow strike from Nicky Holtzkin, the natural.
Oh, that was a great move. though he missed.
Right, but the intention was there.
Yep, yep. Nice.
Swept him right off his feet.
Yeah, it's a nice score. Not that much, but it looks very spectacular, of course.
Of course, he swept this lovely bride off her feet, but not in the same way, I don't think, from Esther.
I don't know.
Here's the natural victory. It's good to Mr. O'Brien, and then some H2O. It's always got to feel good when you've got one of the best combat sports athletes in the world in your corner for added support.
Never bad for your confidence.
No. They touch gloves to start round three. What has been a great technical battle here between Nicky Holtzgen in the white gloves and Marco the Sniper, PK the Black.
You see that they both know they have to do something now.
Both going at it. I mean, PK is initiating, but Holtzgen immediately counters.
He's covering up right away.
Good defense, and there's a nice left. Our punch by PK going to the body downstairs and gets caught with a straight jab. There's a left kick to the body. Oh, I like that combination.
Yeah, but it's not hard enough, which is
no,
good. The
scoring.
Elbow is very good to scoring, and that is important now. Because they're pretty even, I guess, in the round, so...
Do you feel that the fight is up for grabs here in round three?
Yeah, for sure. For sure. But I mean, Marco is doing, it's working a little bit more, but it's not, there's no really... Yeah, no power. There's nothing about what you say. Oh yeah, he's going to be leading.
Countering very effectively. Yeah. There's a jab by PK. Holtzgen goes down, and let's remember the first meeting back in 2008. It ended with 4 seconds left in the final. A lethal left hook from Holtzgen that dropped PK. Oh, there's a right head kick. A nice right round kick to the
head. This is scoring points.
Double left body kick. Oh, the jab. And that pops the head back. Holtzgen can use that jab effectively, but needs to follow up, right? The jab is a range finder, but you gotta use it.
Good down from Marco. He's keeping the pressure now.
Yeah, great fight here between Holtzgen
now, and PK. Up till now, it's PK's round, in my opinion.
A minute left now in the fight. Holtzgen with the left eye head kick, body kick by PK. Right hand connects by Holtzgen. Low leg kick countered by Holtzgen. 45 seconds, jump knee by Holtzgen. Oh! Nicky Holtzgen. Some late round dramatics again. The uppercut. Jackson John PK. Right hand kick. Holtzgen looking to close in impressive fashion. Spinning back elbow. Body shot. Now he's just striking.
Marco looks like he recovered quite okay, but it will not be enough.
I think even though he's recovered, Holtzgen is lighting him up here with all kinds of strikes. Holtzgen indeed may have stolen that at the last stages. I mean, not even stolen. What a performance in the third round.
It is a great, great move. Great moves, great moves.
And again, pro wrestler Rob Van Dam enjoying it.
Being able to do that at the end of the fight, that makes you a champion.
Nicky Holtzgen being feted by Justin McCall. I always get them confused. I mean, there's so many combat sports athletes in attendance here tonight. It's amazing.
It was very enjoyable, and it came from Holland.
There you go, the Dutch style. All right, to make it official, I bet the Dutch guy wins. Let's go to Chris Gregory.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of action, we have your decision. Judge one scores the bout 30-26 in favor, Holtzgen. Judge two sees it 28-28. And judge three has it 29-27 in favor for the winner. By majority decision, in the red corner, Nicky Holtzgen.
So scores were all over the map, an entertaining fight nevertheless, but majority decision win for...
I did not really understand the 28-28.
No, I didn't either, but
that's okay.
The right guy won again, so that's okay. Yeah. 2 points for Holtzgen. A great fight for PK, but falls short in this one via majority decision. So Holtzgen now has 2 wins over the sniper, Marco PK. Of course, Jordan Watson and Kai Hollenbeck, also a part of the Group B contingent. Group A in the middleweight division, Jonsen Clyde Fairtex, one of the top fighters on the planet, Vladimir Moravcik, Johan Lydon, and Rosario Presti, as we revisit the action.
It was the knee that did it. And I think he wasn't that much, that hard rocked. But it was enough.
Nicky, how do you feel? You said you'd beat him again, and you did.
California love. Marco is a great fighter, and I love him. He has good, he gives me a good fight, and I say I beat him, so I did it.
Well, you did it, real. You were a big crowd favorite as well, and they're loving you out there. Congratulations. Great fight. Anything you'd like to say to them out there?
Yeah, I hope to see you in the finals again. And the finals will be mine if I come in the finals. I promise you that. To all my fans who I got here now on my trip, I love America. It's always been a dream for me to come here and fight. So now I'm being here. I win on a great fight. So I think I'm a lucky boy today.
Thank you very much. We're going to see you in Amsterdam, your hometown. Thank you. Great fight.